I'm Gavin Dawson, and welcome in to the Crypto Daily News, available on YouTube, podcast, and streaming on blockchain radio. Thanks for making us part of your day. We'll get the crypto news you can use here in just a minute. First, let's set the scene on the market for you. Bitcoin is sitting in a very tight channel from the upper 47s to mid 48,000s, currently 48,230. Bitcoin dominance 39.8. The total global market cap of the cryptos, 2.289 trillion, sideways last couple days. And the fear and greed index is on 53. Very good recovery from the dump to 30 on Tuesday and now heading back very much towards a more confident market. Winners and losers here over the last 24, Ethereum waking back. Back up. Keep an eye on ETH, up 6%, 36.28 now. Avalanche is back in business doing the bull dance, up 16% on 61.18. Polygon's making a move, up 7% to $1.46. But there are other coins making big moves. SushiSwap up 22% to $15.89. Elio did a video about them. Maybe he's getting a little bit of a social media pump. ThorChain up 15% to $10.69. Horizon, ZEN, up over $100 at $103, thanks to a 19% pump. Not many projects holding the L today. DOT is down 2%. FTX token down 3%. Tezos and Elron pumped hard yesterday. They're down 4% today. And the same thing for Hedera Hashgraph. HBAR down 9% today to go back under 50 cents. All right, time now for some crypto news you can use. And there is a significant amount of Ethereum news coming through. ETH did cross that 3,600 mark, up 6%. We just told you. Now at about 16% from its all-time high of 4,356, which was May 12th, just before the big crash. It is currently the biggest gainer inside the top 10, which might be a sign that it is ETH's turn. This is Ethereum co-founder Vitalik Buterin appeared in Time Magazine's 100 Most Influential People list for 2021 as one of the top innovators in the world. Another story showing how EIP 1559 is impacting the protocol 1 month in. As of this week, over $1 billion worth of ETH has already been burnt since the London hard fork. They have not been able to solve gas fees at this point, but they are making progress in the scarcity department as they're moving over a total of 300,000 coins burnt now. That would mean roughly 10,000 per day. Okay, the other ETH storyline, whales are moving a ton. Over $1 billion worth of the second largest coin shifted across major crypto exchange and wallets on Wednesday alone. Whale Alert tweeting that in the last day, $1 billion shifted, 279,000 ETH moved to and fro major exchanges. The largest one carried over 61,000 coins by itself. Not totally clear what the intentions are, but major players are definitely getting ready to make some ETH moves. The largest exchange in the U.S. announcing some plans. And we get a heads up on what's next for Coinbase. They are seeking futures trading approval and derivatives. The exchange tweeting themselves, they have filed an application to the NFA to register as a futures commission merchant. The application currently pending. Several other exchanges already offering futures. Binance, FTX U.S., Kraken, Hobie, and BitMEX. 9 days into Bitcoin being legal tender in El Salvador, protests continue. Wednesday was the country's Independence Day. Citizens took to the streets to protest. They set fire to a Bitcoin ATM in San Salvador. Meanwhile, Cardano founder Charles Hoskinson says more countries will soon adopt crypto, saying over 100 million people, the majority of people under 25 across the world, have a positive view of crypto, and a lot of them own some. And he says that's the future. Their children will grow up with those values and beliefs about the nature of money. So in a certain respect, Chuck says, we as an industry have already won. And I'll drink to that, Charles. How about it? Both Panama and Ukraine in the news this week, working towards being the next countries to do exactly that. Brian Brian Brooks weighs in on the Senate hearings, Gary Gensler, Elizabeth Warren, and all that, the former comptroller of the currency, and the former Binance U.S. CEO Brooks says not everything in crypto needs to be regulated. He says it's like we're asking the kids selling lemonade to the neighbors to get a health permit, saying it's a weird question. Hey, you're doing something. Now, show me what regulations you're complying with. He was speaking at an institutional adoption of digital assets at the SALT conference, says, quote, I don't start with regulation. I start with what is the activity that we're doing here and what aspects should be regulated. He says the code can serve as the rules for most things. And what is really left is, quote, rules for compensating losses and instituting cybersecurity standards. That's all you need, if you ask me, Brian, and I will drink to that as well. Let's go. Bit Casino and Evil Geniuses have joined forces to create the first crypto-based digital gaming partnership. The esports brand Evil Geniuses will feature Bit Casino branding on uniforms and digital space. Bit Casino has an extensive online casino, including 2,800 games, boasts robust security, and an average withdrawal time of 90 seconds, among the fastest in the industry. Little crypto crime news for you. Former crypto hedge fund manager thrown in the clink for 7 years. Ran a Ponzi. Yeah, 24-year-old Stefan Kin ran Virgil Sigma Fund for 3 years until 2020. Department of Justice says he ran off with almost the entire $90 million that investors had trusted him with. He convinced roughly 100 investors to join, telling them the firm was good at identifying and pursuing traditionally risky indicators like extreme volatility and taking advantage of it through arbitrage opportunities. Authorities say they caught on to it pretty quick because he was claiming to be able to produce gains that were too high to be realistic. He claimed to return more than 100% in 2018 and executed 20 to 60,000 trades per day. Sports crypto news. Serena Williams' husband wore a CryptoPunk NFT to the Met Gala. Yeah, Alexis Ohanian is his name, actually wore a pin depicting the punk that he bought for his wife. According to records, he spent more than $1 million on it. Wanted to show it off, can't blame him. Neighborhood Watch, Bridgewater's Ray Dalio making headlines for his warning about what happens to if Bitcoin becomes too successful. The billionaire was on CNBC.
Do you believe that regulation ultimately will make something like Bitcoin and other cryptocurrencies have a future, or do you think regulation will kill it?
Well, I think regulation, I think at the end of the day, if it's really successful, they'll kill it. And they'll try to kill it, and I think they will kill it because they have ways of killing it. But that doesn't mean it doesn't have, you know, a place, a value and so on.
Ray has been absolutely crushed across social media since saying that, and it was not his best moment, but I think he does bring up an interesting topic. American government could greatly restrict crypto and make it very difficult for people to invest in it inside the U.S., and that would hurt the total market cap and discourage a lot of people who are not hardcore crypto investors. They would just find the path of least resistance for their investments. But here's why it's probably a non-story. The banks want to get rich off cryptos. You see the institutional interest. You see it in the headlines. They are getting involved. And what the banks want in the U.S., they absolutely get. Across the world, they do. It's that simple. The government's never going to kill it because the people who pay for their elections and their seven-figure speeches want to keep it going so they can get even richer. Influencer Lark Davis with a series of tweets on Polkadot saying it's been one of the biggest pre-launch chains in terms of developer commitment, points out it's the most held asset by VCs and hedge funds as well. Your guy Michael Vandepop says he expects Chainlink to make a run soon, saying it's very likely that we're going to have a breakout happening here, looking at a rounded bottom, which is usually a very good thing. He says we're going to have higher lows and higher highs swiftly, and says the key level to stay above is 2887. Thanks for checking in on the CDN. Please subscribe, like, follow, comment, or just continue to listen. We sure would appreciate it. For the GD Crypto News Team, covering the world of crypto one Satoshi at a time, I'm Gavin Dawson. At ease.